Sa inyong lahat. Good morning, brothers and sisters. Magandang umaga sa ating simbahan, ang Christ-Centered Family Fellowship Church. Let us now prepare ourselves. Today is Sunday, and our Sunday service online will start now. At itong araw na to ay napakaganda sapagkat itong buwan na to ay buwan ng pagmamahal, month of February. At i-spread po natin ang pagmamahal na to na ibinibigay sa atin ng Diyos. Mahalin po natin ang ating kapwa. Mahalin natin ang ating sarili. Mahalin natin ang ating mga kasamahan sa trabaho. Hindi lamang ang ating loved ones, kundi lahat ng mga taong dumadaan sa ating buhay, mahalin po natin sila. Okay, so ikaw na nagkakape, be ready. So prepare na ourselves. Ihanda po natin ating sarili, ang ating isipan, ang ating puso, lalong-lalo na sapagkat ngayon ay araw ng Linggo, ang ating Sabbath day, at ngayong araw ay mapapakinggan na naman natin ang ating mahal na Diyos through the words, through our pastors, at maraming salamat sa opportunity na to na ibinigay sa atin ng Diyos upang may pakita natin ating pagmamahal sa Kanya through our worship. So, let us prepare ourselves. Open up our Bibles to Psalm 96. Psalm 96 from verse 1 to verse 13. So, simulan ko na po. Verse 1, sing to the Lord the new song. Sing to the Lord all the earth. Sing to the Lord, praise His name, proclaim His salvation day after day. Declare His glory among the nations, His marvelous deeds among all peoples. For great is the Lord and most worthy of praise. He is to be feared above all gods, for all gods of the nations are idols. But the Lord made heavens. Splendor and majesty are before Him. Strength and glory are in His sanctuary. Ascribe to the Lord, O families of nations. Ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory due His name. Bring an offering and come into His courts. Worship the Lord in the splendor of His holiness. Tremble before Him all the earth. Say among the nations, the Lord reigns. The world is firmly established. It cannot be moved. He will judge the peoples with equity. Let the heavens rejoice. Let the earth be glad. Let the sea resound and all that is in it. Let the fields be jubilant and everything in them. Then all the trees of the forest will sing for joy. They will sing before the Lord, for He comes to judge the earth. He will judge the world in righteousness and the people in His truth. So blessed be the reading of the Word of God. And now let us pray. Almighty Father in heaven, we thank you, Lord God, for this day. We thank you for this opportunity again. Thank you, Lord, for giving us new life, new hope, and Lord God, a new promise. Lord, maraming salamat sa araw na to, Panginoon, sapagkat buhay pa kami. Linisin mo po aming puso, patawarin mo po ang aming mga kasalanan, O God, patawarin mo po ang aming pagkukulang, at naway makausap ka namin, Panginoon, sa araw na ito. We will worship you, and we will praise you, O God. Lord, salamat sa pagiging faithfulness, Lord God, even sa mga pagsubok namin na pagdadaanan, you are still faithful to us, O God. Maraming salamat, Panginoon, sa aming mga pinagdadaan ng pagsubok na aming nalalagpasan sapagkat Ikaw ang nagbibigay ng kalakasan sa amin, O God. Father, we thank you for all the protections, for the good health and strength that you are extending to us, O God. Lord, maraming salamat sa pag-bless mo sa iyong mga kaanakan. Salamat sa pag-bless mo po sa aming church, the Christ-Centered Family Fellowship Church. At salamat, Lord God, sa lahat ng miyembro namin, Lord God, na nagiging blessings, Lord God, sa aming mga kapitbahay, sa aming mga nakakasalubong at katrabaho, God. Father, we thank you for everything that you have done in our lives, O God. Continue, Lord. Continue, Lord God, to make us a blessing to others, O God. Father, we thank you and we give you back the glory, honor, and praises, O God. In your name, Lord Jesus, we pray. Amen, amen, and amen. Good morning, everyone. Hallelujah.
Failed us, Lord God, not even once, Lord. Hallelujah. You are a faithful God, Lord God. We will see your miracles and we will see you do it again. Let's sing. Walking around these walls, I thought by now they'd fall, but you have next door. In my heart, 'cause you loved me right from the start. When I was refusing, your love kept pursuing. Now that I've tasted your love, my heart just can't get enough. Jesus, you have me, you have me completely. It's your love in my heart running over, yeah. Every day of my life I'll draw closer.
Sa tanan, mga kaigsuunan. Welcome to the Christ-Centered Family Fellowship Sunday Online Worship Service. We are a Davao City-based church, and our church teaches only from the Holy Bible. Our church, my kaigsuun, does not promote any religion, but what we are after is introducing you to a special and intimate relationship with our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Because in the end, mga kaigsuun, that is what it matters most. Ang atong relasyon diha kay Jesus Christ, awang Ginoo ug manluluwas. Once again, thank you, Mike Zone, for joining us today. We believe that it's not an accident na naamudiri karon. We believe that God has a word for each and every one of us today. Amen. And once again, Ixon, we thank you for your presence. And before we go sa message ni Lord, we'd like to invite everyone to bow down their heads. Let us pray and invite the presence of God. Let us pray. Our Father in heaven, precious Holy Spirit, Lord, good morning. Lord, we praise you and we worship you, Lord. For you alone are God and you alone are Lord. You alone are worthy, God, to be praised and to be worshipped, Lord. Walang sama ni mo, Lord. Walang katulad sa iyo, O God. Ikaw lang, Lord, ang muniga simba. Ikaw lang, Lord, ang muniga saligan, Lord. O ikaw lang din ang pag-asa, ang paglaom sa among kinabuhi, O God. Today, Lord, as we listen to your word, Lord, we pray, O God, grant us, Lord, a heart, Lord, that is receptive, O God, to your word. A heart and spirit, Lord, that is willing to be taught, O loving God. And whatever we hear today, Lord, whatever the message from you today, O God, amo di siyang ikinabuhi, Lord. Amo siyang i-apply sa mong life, O God, so we can become the kind of persons that you want us to be, O God. Lord, salamat, Lord, for your word today, O God. We invite your presence, Holy Spirit. Ikaw ang magdumala, Lord. Ikaw ang mag-guide, Lord. Sa tanan-tanan, Lord, ang message ni mo karong buntaga kanamo, Lord. And before anything else, O God, we'd like to ask also for forgiveness, Lord, for all of our sins, O God. We know that we are not perfect, Lord. We have our faults, our shortcomings, O God. But you are a gracious God, Lord, a God who is loving and willing to forgive us as we confess our sins, O Lord. And so right now, God, we confess of our sins, Lord, the sins of our thoughts, motives, and intentions, O God, and even for the things that we have failed to do, Lord. Pasailuan mo, O God, cleanse us with your most precious blood, Lord Jesus, Lord, and make us worthy, God, to be called your children, to be called your family, Lord. Thank you once again for everything, O God. We just give you back the glory, Lord. The honor and the praises, Lord, whatever we achieve today, Lord, ikaw lang mahimaya, ikaw lang, wala na ilain pa, O Diyos. In the name of Jesus we pray. Amen and amen. Good morning once again, mga Ixoon. And today is iyon pala isla February 2022. They say it's the love month. And actually, Ixoon, love should not be only sa February, but all throughout sa year. Amen. So today, mga Ixoon, I would like to talk as God led me to a topic about loving our families. Amen? But before that, I'd like to introduce to you, Ixon, ang church, ang Christ-Centered Family Fellowship, among vision, mission, and core values. Amen? Ang vision sa church is this, Ixon, to multiply Holy Spirit-empowered leaders, helping people become Christ-like in character, and serving as agents of change in their families, communities, and into the nations of the world. Amen? O ang mission, Ixon, is this, to develop, motivate and equip the church to discipleship, practicing the core values. Amen. And the core values are the following. Number one, passionate spirituality expressed through prayer, fasting and holiness, submission to authority, commitment to time, loyalty to one another, compassion to the needy, and faithfulness in tithing. Amen. That's what we are, Ixon, the Christ-Centered Family Fellowship, the church that welcomes you as you are. Amen. So going back to our topic soon, ang title for our topic for Sunday today is Loving the Family. Amen? Atong higugmaon ang atong pamilya, whether it be our biological family and labaw na atong spiritual family. Amen? Okay. I'll start it soon. Ang ato ang main verse is found in 1 John chapter 3 verse 18. Kung ang Word of God says through the Apostle John, "Dear children, let us not love with words or speech, but with actions and in truth." Amen? So, dali ilang soon, magsulti, "I love you," di ba? That's, sa'yo na po, masayo, no? Kanang himo na maguna-una ka lang, nagimahal mo isang katao. But ingon pa ang Word of God through the Apostle John na maghigugma tayo soon, di lang sa atong words, di lang sa atong speech, malabaw na soon sa atong actions o sa ato ang sa kamatuuran ba? Kanang tinud-anay dyan ganin na paghigugma sa atong isang katao. And I'll start up soon with a story. There was a story I read na there isa kababae Ixoon na nagsimba sila sa ilang church. She was a loyal member sa ilang church. And one Sunday morning, before the service started, Ixoon, tingala siya. E katong babae, na kanang dugi na siya ni Gasnab, gani, na may tao nga na, di ba? Kanang isa kababae, member sa church, Ixoon, na kanang di siya nagapansin, and then was siya kabalong anong nani siya kasuko sa kuha. But on that particular Sunday, Ixoon, na tingala siya kay gigako siya sa babae, gi-embrace siya sa babae, and then isa the lady told her, "I love you with the love of the Lord." So dako niya katingala, she was amazed. Uy, unsa may nakapagpagos yang unahuna? Ang answer is so nadawat niya at the end of the service when the pastor said after the word na, "Okay church, ang inyong assignment for today or next week I mean is the same as last week. Last week your assignment was to love those people na di mo gustong higugmaon or lisod na higugmaon." And then the lady thought, "Ah, mo ditong rason. Rason nganong iya kong gigakos kay nag-ingon si pastor." Like so on, kung ang paggakos sa isa ka tao o ang pag-say o I love you without meaning it is kanang maulay kanang way na malove nimo para ma-fulfill nimo ang sugo ni Lord to love all people, siguro kitang tananig soon mag-excel. Kitang tananig soon taas na grado. Kung ang basihan lang gani Diyod sa paghigugma is kanang mo embrace gani ikaw mo say I love you, siguro kita tananaw makapasar Diyod. Di man, isod mo gakos, di ba? Amen? But mind you, soon, ang paghigugma daw is a little bit more harder than that. Ingon palagi, soon, ang paghigugma, love is a continual effort. It is hard, soon, it is difficult. Ano man? Because at the heart of loving other people is putting that person's interest ahead of yours. Meaning, kung gihigugma nimo igsoon ang isa ka tawo, whether it be romantic love or kanang love nimo sa imong parents, imong anak, or whoever igsoon, it is that means na imong giuna ang ilang kapakanan before your own. That's what love is igsoon. And that's what we will be learning today from the word of God. Amen. Kay ingon palagi ang tao mang good, ang atong default mode gani, selfishness. Amen. Kita kag baby gani, kanang baby na bago pa gud siyang gitawo. Or kanang maski 2 years, 2 months old na siya igsoon. Pakita nimo sa bata na ang kanang ganing selfishness o self-centered na nagani. Diba ang kanang baby, muhilak na siya igsoon. Kanto di niya makuha yung gusto, di na siya mumunong. And then kung makita ka ng mga duwa ka baby na magdula, mag-inilugay na sila sa dulaan. Because noon palagi, ang basic instinct sa tao is selfishness. That's why today, by the grace of God, magtuong tayo igsoon. Unsa dyan ang gitawag na biblical definition of love. And I pray and I hope na ato dyan na siyang matunan karong buntaga mga igsoon. Si John igsoon, ang apostle ni Lord, gusto dyan siya na makasiguro na kitang tanan, may numduman, unsa dyan ang paghihugma sa isig katawo. That's why in his letter in 1 John chapter 3 and chapter 4, gibalik-balik dyan ni John igsoon ang mga paluwing na mga pagpahinumdum. Actually, gikan ni kay Lord Jesus, gamit lang siya as spokesperson, as mouthpiece. Iyon pa si Apostle John Mike, so in verse 11, iyon siya na, "For this is the message you heard from the beginning, we should love one another." Amen? Ako lang i-underlinean para mas may emphasize. In verse 13 at 23, iyon siya, "And this is his command, that to believe in the name of his son, Jesus Christ, and to love one another as he commanded us." Amen? Please take note, Ikson, as he commanded us. In the next chapter, Ikson, same book, ingon pa si John, in verse 7, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who has been born of God knows God." Meaning, Ikson, ang tanan daw, Ikson, na kanang nahigugma kay Lord, mahigugma po sa isig katawo. And in verses 11 and 12, gipadayon ni John, ingon siya, igsoon, "Dear friends, since God so loved us, let we also ought to love one another." Sabi ni saya pa, kay gigugma man ta sa Ginoo, higugmaon po nato atong isig katawo. In verse 12, igsoon, "No one has ever seen God." Wala may nakita sa tuwa, di ba? Sa tinuod lang. "But if we love one another, God lives in us and His love is made complete in us." Si Apostle John, Ikson, the one that Jesus loved, ingon pa siya sa pag-describe siya yung sarili, wants us to learn how to love. Kaya ingon pa lang, Ikson, love is more than just a sentimental feeling. Love is more than just an emotion. Amen? O sa akin, Manggod, Ikson, magamit na to ang I love na kanang phrase gani sa kanang butang, yung gap. I love my dog, di ba? I love my cat. I love reading books. I love playing basketball. I love watching TV. Yung pagkana, I love my house. I love my career. And then you also say, I love my family. I love my parents, my spouse. Tingala kay Igsoon, we use the word love sa halos tanang butang. When in the sense, Igsoon, love is more than just a like feeling. Love is more than just kanang murag sentimental feeling, emotions na Igsoon. But love actually is more than that. Love is much deeper than that. Amen? Here's another story, Igsoon. Na isa kababae daw, nakibreak siya sa iyang boyfriend. Amen? And then one day, natingala iyang boyfriend ni Son. Tingala siya kay nagsulat tong iyang former girlfriend na mo'y nakibulag sa iya. Ingon pa sa letter ni Son, ingon ang babae, kanang wala joy words na maka-express sa akong kamingaw. Sukad nagbulag ta. Siya nagimingaw doon siya sa iyang boyfriend ni Son. And then siya na, please say that you'll accept me again. Ingon siya, dawat ako kay wa joy laing gimahal na ko kundi ikaw. Ingon siya, I love you. Ang problema, Igsoon, kasi tumoy sa letter, na siya PS ka ng pahabol gani. Siya PS, kung congrats di ay, kaya nakadaog ka sa loto, 30 million. In essence, Igsoon, the motive of that girl na makibalik siya ang boyfriend is questionable, di ba? Siguro nakibalik siya tungod sa gidagan sa sweepstake or whatever gidagan, Igsoon. Gigamit niya ang word na I love you, no one can ever take your place in my heart. Pero ang motive na Igsoon is nakadaog siya sa sweepstake or whatever gidagan na ito yung old boyfriend. And so today, Igsoon, we'll be learning from the Word of God. We know that the Word of God is the only source of truth. The Word of God is the only thing that can teach us how to live. And so, Igsoon, kung mag-rely ta sa definition sa world, sa love, malimog ta, mawala ta, Igsoon. But if we rely sa definition sa love, sa Word from God, sa Bible, Igsoon, then we will not go astray. Meaning, dili tayo, Igsoon, mahisaad. Amen? Kaingon palagi si Apostle John, Igsoon, love is not an optional virtue. Dili siya option, Igsoon, but instead, love is a distinguishing mark of a Christian in the world. So kung gusto ni mo na mailang ka sa mga tao, Igsoon, na pistohanon ka, nagsunod ka kay Jesus Kristo, show to them, Igsoon, ang love na gikan sa imong kasing-kasing. Of course, magbasa ka sa Bible, mag-pray ka, mag-join ka fellowship, mag-serve ka sa ministry. But ang nigatanaw ba yung sa tao, Igsoon, more than those things, is kung tinud-anay ba dyan ang pag-igugman ni mo sa imong isikatawo. Amen? So that's why today, Igsoon, we learn how the Bible defines love. Amen? Are you ready? Point number one, Igsoon. Point number one, biblical love seeks the highest good of others. Meaning, ang gugma da Igsoon na itudlo sa Bible, ang iyang tinguha, ang iyang tumoy, ang iyang purpose is ang kaayuhan sa laing tao. Amen? It's more than yourself, Igsoon. It's the goodness of other people. Iyon pa sa notes, Igsoon, biblical love is a commitment that is not without feeling. It is caring. Of course, love involves feeling. Amen? But it is also a caring commitment. In other words, Igsoon, biblical love involves not just delight, but also a feeling, Igsoon. Ingon palagi, biblical love involves delight, not just a duty. Kung ikaw isa kaanak gani, siguro ma-feel ni mo na duty mo dyan ako na alagaan at kung ginikanan, mas gulang na sila, that's good. But kung love dyan ang pagbasihan, Igsoon, di lang siya duty dapat na imong batiyan, kundi commitment and delight. Kana malipay kay ka na pagsilbihan gani sila. Amen? And then, Igsoon, another thing, this caring commitment also is not just an attitude, but it is an action. Ingon palagi, magkunsa na naman ang dagang kayong words, dagang kayong sulat, pero walay action. Ingon palagi, Igsoon, kung faith man ito yan, faith without action is dead. Just like love without action is dead. Amen? Kaya bago tanga-tanga, Igsoon, ingon ba, you can give without loving, but you cannot love without giving. Amen? So that's why, ang biblical definition sa love is putting others above yourself. Kanang unahan pa rin mo, Igsoon, sila kaysa imuha. Unsa may commitment nato, Igsoon, isip kita na mga nagigugma sa mga tao. Siguro ang goal nato sa commitment nato sa tong family is to provide for them. Amen? To provide for their food, their shelter, sa ilang pag-skwela. Amen? Also, to a higher degree, committed na igsoon na kanang tabangan sila na ma-achieve ilang dreams. Amen? Na makuha nila ng mga damgo sa kinabuhi. Nahatagan nato sila self-worth that will assure them igsoon na na sila'y bilig diri sa kalibutan. But the highest commitment igsoon for a Christian just like you and me is for us to help that person know Jesus Christ. Mo din ay pinakatumong igsoon, pinakataas igsoon, pinakalalom natong commitment dapat na ang tao natong gihigugma, madala nato sila sa Ginoo. Amen. Madala nato sila sa Ginoo, and then we will see little, by the grace of God, glory to glory igsoon, mausab ang ilang panglantaw sa kinabuhi, musunod sila kay Jesucristo, and then they will be conforming to the image of Christ. Amen. So that's why kung ang love igsoon is a commitment, meaning, it may be commanded. Kung commitment ang love, so on, pwede siyang isugo. Which brings me to my second point. Ang second point is this. Christian love, what we are talking about today, fulfills the command of Christ. Kung mahigugma data sa atong isig katawo, atong nigasunod ang sugo ni Jesucristo. In 1 John 3 verse 11, ingon pa ang word of God, for this is the message you heard. From the beginning, we should love one another. Please take note, mga igsoon, the Apostle John is writing these things. Amen? But he is not actually the author of love. Diligikan sa igsoon ang kanagaling ang idea of loving other people. In fact, if you read your Bible, si John isa siya gitawag na sons of thunder. Kaya kanang dali mo init yung ulo. Gusto siya makig-away igsoon. But when he met Jesus Christ, read your Bible, he was converted, igsoon, not to a religion, but to something that is deeper than a religion, a relationship with Jesus Christ. That's why si John, Apostle John, from being called a son of thunder, he's now become a son of love. Meaning, kanang ang gugma, igsoon, nag-urus-urus, nag-apaw-apaw sa iyang kasing-kasing. That's why si John, dili siya ang author sa love, it is God. Amen? Kasi God, mga igsoon, ang nagsugo sa tua na mahigugma sa matag-usa. Ang word si Jesus Christ, igsoon, in John chapter 3, verses 34 to 35, iyon pa sa word of God, si Jesus Christ mismo nag-ingon, mga igsoon, a new command I give you, love one another. As I have loved you, so you must love one another. By this, all men will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. So ayon pa kay Jesus Christ igsoon, fundamental to daw sa mga Kristohanon ang gugma. Pangutana, if people judge your Christian life on the basis of your love for brothers and sisters in Christ, would you pass the test? Meaning, kung ang sukdanan daw para mapatunayan na Kristohanon ka o nagsunod ka kay Jesus Christ is ang level sa pag-gugma nimo sa tao igsoon, mupasar kaya ta? Kay mismong si Jesus Christ igsoon nag-ingon, if you go back to 34 to 35, ingon pa siya, by this all men will know that you are my disciples if you love one another. Mismong si Jesus Christ igsoon nag-ingon na ang kalibutan mag-judge sa inyo ha, kung nagsunod mo kanako, pinaagi sa inyong pagigugma sa matag usa. Amen. Ang early church, if you read the Bible, so if you also read the history of the church, they love one another. In the book of Acts, gani, narito yung nakabutang, di ba, sa kapasis na gibaligyan nila ang tanan nilang kabtangan, whatever they have sold it, and so on, o ang tanan nilang halin, wala nila gibutang sa bangko, wala nila gitaguan, gigamit nila para masuplayan itong mga kaigsuunan na kulang sa supply. So the Old Testament people, and so on, they showed love for each other. Ang pangutana karon sa atong generation 2022 and forward. Masulti ka sa mga tao, sa mga unbelievers especially, na higugma juta sa matag usa. Kaya absence of love judiksoon actually is inconsistent sa isa Kristohanon na nagclaim na Kristohanon siya. Igsoon, Christian love is conditional to being a child of God. Meaning, dili ka matawag na Kristohanon kung duwa ka giso na higugma sa imong isig katawo. I would like to make that clear. Ang tao sa kalibutan ni Son, the unbelievers, those who are observing us, ang ilan ni katanaw giso sa tinood lang, dili atong words, dili na unsa ka hawd ka muwali, dili na unsa kataas ka magampo, kundi kung yun sa nimo gihigmug, gihigugma igsoon ang mga tao, labaw na itong mga tao na lisod, igugmaon. Amen? Point number three, igsoon. Believers' love to one another is evidence of salvation. Okay? In 1 John chapter 3, verses 14 to 15, yun pang word of God, igsoon, we know that we have passed from death to life because we love our brothers. Anyone who does not love remains in death. Anyone who hates his brother is a murderer, and you know that no murderer has eternal life in him. So klaro kayo mga igsoon sa word of God na kung para makapasar ka from kamatayon to eternal life igsoon, ang basis yun daw is love. Kay John igsoon, Apostle John, sukad ganin na convert siya sa relationship niya kay Hesu Kristo, klaro na siya igsoon, there are no shades of gray. In siya walay gray area igsoon, it's either black or it's either white. It's either you're a son of God or you're a son of the devil. It's either you are a child, a believer or an unbeliever. Ayon pa rin igsoon, ang duha ra jud ang classification, whether Christian ka or dili ka Christian. All of us can claim that we are Christians igsoon, but only one test can prove if it's true. Ang gugma nimo sa imong isig katawo. So ingon pa rin, becoming a Christian is not earned by loving the family. Amen? Dili nimo makabutan ang salvation igsoon, mahimo kang Christian, pinagi na sa gugma sa pamilya. Ayun mo palagi, our salvation is by faith of what Jesus Christ has done on the cross for us. But rather, loving the family is proof that one has made the transition from a child of the devil to a child of God. Amen? Love for the family, therefore, so is evidence of salvation, not the means of salvation. Ano ako maning emphasize, igsoon? Ayun palagi, kung nahigugma jud ka sa Ginoo igsoon, nawa nimo nakita as you are claiming, then nothing should stop you from loving people na imo makita. Whether unlovable sila or dili sila unlovable depende sa standard na imo gigamit igsoon, but the fact remains that kung ang Ginoo nawa nimo nakita, you are claiming that you love God, how much more you can love people na imo makita igsoon. Biases or no biases igsoon. That's why kung nag-alaanig ka sa imong salvation gani, ikaw na ka na, sibod yung baya ako, no? Check your love quotient and so on. Kung naman tayo IQ, intelligence quotient, o naman tayo EQ, emotional quotient, napot tayo LQ and so on. Dili, lovers quarrel lang, kundi love quotient. Kung murag alaanig ka sa imong salvation, murag, sibod ako, dili. Even if you have made that decision and so on to accept Christ, pinahagig soon sa imong pag-check sa imong love quotient, kung tinud-anay mo dyan ang pangigugman nimo sa imong sikatawag soon, then you will know na genuine judoy na nidawat ko kay Jesus Christ. Kaya nga no, nausab man imong life, nausab man imong batasan, nausab man imong pagtagad sa mga tawag soon, maskin ka itong mga diring mga tao na lisod gani, higugmaon gani. That's why loving others, especially when they are unloving and don't deserve it, is a sign that you are part of God's family. Pastor, lisod mo siya higugmaon eh, kay hasta diyong maldituha. Pastor, lisod mo siya sabton, kay hindi na ko siya kanang, hindi na ko siya masabtan na siya sariling mundo. Sa tinood lang, Joe Dixon, loving the kato gani, murag ikaw deliverty gani, is a sign that you are part of God's family. And even most especially, Dixon, loving those people na di na kayo makabalo sa imuha gani. That's why, blessed jud kayo igsoon katong mga tao gani, mga Kristohanon, na na sila yung mga senior citizens sa ilang balay. Mga senior citizens na di na gani makabalos o tabang o di magsigil na gani sugo. Mga senior citizens igsoon na kanang ikaw na gani mismo ang makasakaso sila from day one, from day in to day out igsoon. Blessed po itong mga anak gani, mga special children na di mo masabtan sila, but again, you are still there taking care of them, loving them, maski di sila nag-reciprocate gani. Sa tinulay, igsoon, blessed yun itong mga tawhana because they are showing the love, the kind of love that Christ is teaching us, igsoon. Loving the unlovable, loving those, even those who cannot love us in return. That's why, igsoon, Kuna kay nagalagaan karon na murag lisod na kay pastor hago na magkayo. But you know that it's the right thing to do kay tigulang na siya, special child siya o na siya sakit gani. You are blessed because God has given you an opportunity to show to the world that you are indeed a child of God. Amen. Point number 4 is on. Usa man dayang love. Usa man dayang ang love, pastor? Okay. Since we are talking about love as defined by the Bible, ang pinaka-example na ito, Ikson, should be our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Point number 4, Jesus' love is illustrated by His sacrifice. Ikson, ingon ang Word of God in verse John 3:16, and this is how we know what love is. Jesus Christ laid down His life for us. Ang pinaka-taas, Ikson, pinaka-super-duper, Ikson, na kanang mahimo nimo when you love a person is to give your life. Ingon palagi, ang laid down, as Jesus laid down His life, Ikson, involves a deliberate, willful act that demonstrated His love for us. Meaning, Ikson, will ni Kristo na muadto sa cross para sa tuwa. Yes, granted, of course, ingon siya na kung pwede lang lagi amahan, mulampas ni sa tuwa, ingon siya sa word, di ba, sa Bible. But not my will, but your will be done. Kaya nga naman, love man ni Lord ang mga tao. That's why, Ikson, if you want to really show love to people, give them a part of your life. Ingon palagi, unsa man ang pinaka-importanting butang sa mong Ikson, imo bang kutse, imo bang studies, imo bang relationship with other people, imo habang bank account, imo bang career. Sa tinuod, Ikson, sa tinuod na lang, ang pinaka-precious na para sa imo, di ba, is imong kinabuhi. Amen? Your life. Because that is you, Ikson. Kung gani, basic instinct dyan sa tao ang gitawag na self-preservation. Amen? Tanaw, pagod, di ka gusto magutom, God, kihadlok ka mamatay. Amen? Kung na yung mga sitwasyon, Ikson, na murag alanganin ka, bukap yun, good ka, di ba? Tanaw, mugunit yun ka na di ka matagak because your life is precious to you, Ikson. That's why, if you love people, ang pinaka-highest nimo na proof is to give them your life. Not necessarily, Ikson, pinagi sa pagpakamatay sa ilaha. Although, usahay siguro, Ikson, yung mga time na it is what is kanang required, gani, Ikson. Kana ganing required ba na kanang magpakamatay tayo sa katao because love na to sila, but that is the kanang extreme, Ikson. What I'm talking about is this, Ikson. If you want a portrait of love, let us look to the life of Jesus. Ano na kayo mako na si Jesus atong portrait of love, Ikson? Kung basahon na ito ang Bible, si Jesus Christ, He lived on earth. Amen? But all throughout sa iyang 33 years of life, Ikson, sa kalibutan, kanang ipakita doon niya ang gugma, maski asa siya buwad to. Amen? Wala siya nag-discriminate maski sa mga tao na naay leprosy. Amen? Kaya itong panahon na Ikson, kanang ang basang tao, leper ganyan, eh, leprosy, kanang outcast sa society ba? O wala po siya, Ikson, nag-distinguish between Jews and Samaritans. Jesus Christ broke barriers just to show love to people. And then wala po siya nasuko. Nasuko lang siya, Ikson, one time, batong ipangyabuto niya sa temple gani, because kanang gidesecrate man nila ang temple of God. O masuko lang si Jesus Christ, Ikson, as you read the Bible, because He is doing it because naay mga gidaog-daog ng mga tao. In short, Ikson, Jesus Christ lived a perfect life. A perfect life of love. And if you want, and me, if we want Ikson to have a model sa love, let us follow the life of Jesus Christ. Mura ganig, o ang sacrifice, ang pinaka-sacrifice ni Lord Ikson, aside sa mga miracles niyang gihimo, is katong He went to the cross. He went to die on the cross for you and for me, Ikson, to pay the penalty of our sins. It's as if, ipangutanay sa si Jesus Christ, doon sa manimo kamahal ang kalibutan. And when He stretched His arms and so on sa cross, sama ra sa ringo siya ng inyong ani na kukagugma ang tibuok kalibutan. Inyong ani kalapad, inyong ani kadako ang gugma na ko sa ilaha. That's why, Ikson, if you and me want to have a portrait of love, if you want to have a model, Ikson, we must not look to people because people, Ikson, will fail just like you and me. We must look to the life of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen? Because yun palagi sa itong point number 4, Ikson, Jesus' love is illustrated by His sacrifice. One more thing, Ikson, about this point. Isa sa mga butang na di na nimo mabawi ganig suban once you give it away, dili man imong kwarta, because money can be earned, right? The most important part of your life na mahatag nimo gani as proof of your love is your time. Kaya ang time igsoon, set man dyan na siya. Okay? Ang karong, ang this very hour igsoon, paglabay ani, di na siya mabalik igsoon. Memories na lang na siya. And then, you must have given a part of your life sa dihang gitagad di mo isig katao. Time na dapat gi-spend di mo sa imong sarili. Time na dapat gitulog di mo. Time na dapat imo siyang gibuhat sa imong hobby. But you chose to give that time to your elderly parents. You chose to give that time to your special children. You chose to give that time to reaching out to people, preaching the word of God. Maski wala kayo makuha igsoon na ng financial benefits after igsoon. Muna igsoon ang part sa imong life, a sacrifice so to speak, na mahimo nimo just to show the world that you are a child of God. Amen? Because ang atong model is si Jesus Christ, our Lord. Which brings me igsoon sa akong last point. Pastor, kung ang highest form of sacrifice na is giving your life, does it mean na kita po tanan magpakamatay, physically magpakamatay? In extreme cases, igsoon, pwede. But point number five is something that all of us can do. Point number five is Christian love is expressed by actions, personal and practical. Amen? There's the story, igsoon. Nakinabasa ang story na a man who is a Christian, inudan na Christian jud ha, kanang nag-serve sa church, and then, glampo niya iyang pamilya, igsoon. One day, he made a promise to God. He said na, Lord, I love you, Lord, muhatag ko kay US man setting ani. Lord, muhatag ko $10,000 sa imuha. Ihatag na ko sa simbahan. It's over and above my tithes. Offering, in short, offering niya gani, it's over and above my tithes. I'm giving 10,000 to you, Lord, because I love you. Ingon si Lord sa iyang dream, ingon siya, Lord, na instead of giving it sa kuha, edi mo ko rin makita, why not give it every day to people who are in need? Siguro, usay mo, hatagag $1, $5, $10 sa mga tao na nanginahanglan dyan. So, ingon palagi, ang love daw nato, if you want really to show it, if you want people to know that we are full of love, we have to show it. Amen? Ngayon pa igsoon in chapter 3, verses 16 to 18 sa 1 John, yun pa ang word of God, and we ought to lay down our life for our brothers. If anyone has material possessions and sees his brother in need, but has no pity on him, how can the love of God be in him? Dear children, let us not love with words or tongue, but with actions and in truth. Christian love is personal. Christian love is practical. Amen? Kung yung mabasaan ni Son, ang passage diha, yun pa si Apostle John Nixon. If you notice in verse 16, ang gigamit niya na words sa brothers is plural. Nay S, di ba? It is, we ought to lay down our life for our brothers, meaning daghan tao igsoon. But in verse 17, he made a dramatic cambio igsoon. Kung basahin in verse 17 ko na, if anyone has material possessions and sees his brother in need, take to igsoon, brother na lang, wala na S, meaning singular na. In verse 16, John was talking about kadaghanan, the whole of people, the whole of the community. But in verse 17, he talked about a personal, kanang personal relation gani, igsoon. There's a point in this, nga nung gianan ni John, from plural to singular. Kaya ngun palagi, sayon lang baya, igsoon, nung ingunta na, I love the church, I love the people of God, I love humanity, I love those people na nag-serve sa Ginoo. But, sa tinulik, igsoon, kaya rin mo higugmaon, katong kaoban nimo sa balay na badlungon, kaya ka nimo gihugmaon igsoon ang tao na imong gipakaslan na hantud karon kasal pa mo, kaya ka nimo gihugmaon igsoon ang anak nimo na nang wala nagtarong og eskwela but nala siya problem siguro na kailangan nimo siyang i-mentor. So that's why ingon palagi sayon mo ingon na I love the church, daghan guna siya, di ba? But sometimes lisod igsoon mayon ka na I love this and this person. Sample lesson. Reality test. Kung ikaw nasa highway, naglakaw or nagdrive ka for sa kanang son, and then there's someone, a beggar, na nidur sa emuha o nangayo. And you see, so nangayo is kanang genuine yung ganiyang need. Kung ikaw Kristuhanon, madiscern man yun mo ba kung kanang kanitawahan na gani, kanang nangayo ko siya na tungod walang wala siya or nangayo lang siya kay tungod na sa edisyo. Pangutana is, unay mo dul ana sa emuha son, whether you are walking or you are driving your car, or pasahero ka ba sa jeep na nainisakang nangayo ka rin ikson? Ang pangutanan ako is this, personal one. Muligi ka ka sa pika-side, di ka din mo siya tagdun ikson. It's as if mag-pretend ka na wali mo siya nakita, or muhatag ka ikson with all of your heart. Kaingon palagi, sayon mo ingon na I love the church, but can you say that you love that beggar, maski wali mo nakailag ikson na niduol sa imuha? That's why, lisod ikson ang gugma. Sa pagsugod pala, ikson, ingon palagi na kung ang gugma lang is pinaagi lang sa paggakos gani, kita tanan mo pasar. But dili mang gudyan na human, ikson. Our love should be expressed also sa tuang actions. Amen. Kung saan na lang, pastor, kung naapoy kauban sa balay na nakasala sa kuwa, kung saan kung buhaton, pigugmaon siya. Kung saan na lang, pastor, kung ganang tao na ganang sige kasuko sa kuwa, o kasabot, muna magsapoton siya, higugmaon ni mo siya. Kung saan na lang, pastor, kung na yung tao na ganang, maski kung saan na kung tagad, it's a puro, kapagod siya siya, ha? Higugmaon ni mo siya. Kayo sa'yo, hindi mo palagitan na, pastor, masayon pa, mga kusog durian ba, kaysa gakson siya. Sa tinood like son, mo na yung test karon. If there's a person in your life, na listod yung kahigugmaon, ikson, by the grace of God, I encourage you, Ikson, to approach that person, embrace him, and tell that person that you love that person. But it doesn't end there, amen? Because you have to show that person na gihugmanin mo siya. Because, Ikson, ingon palagi, Christian love doesn't just say, I love you. Christian love, it gets its hands dirty, it feel its feet dusty, and its heart engaged. Meaning, kung nagigugma sa kasi sa katawag, Ikson, willing ka na imong kamot mahugaw. Kung sa mga napasabot, pastor, parang maglimpyo kasi ilang balay, mutabang ka, hugas plato, mutabang ka, glaba, whatever. It's feet dusty, meaning willing ka, Ikson, na maski kanang nagising na imong sinilas, muadto, gyapon ka dito, balang magkaabog-abog imong tiil, kaya na siya, gaping na hanglan. And finally, your heart engaged. Meaning, ang imong kasing-kasing na dito sa diyang mitabang ka sa iyaha. You are not just there physical, but you are also there emotional and all that you are, Ikson. That's why Christian love, it means that you are willing to get your hands dirty, your feet dusty, and your heart engaged. Amen? Because, ang point number 5, Ikson, is this. Christian love is expressed by actions, practical, and personal. I'll end up with this story, Ikson. Dili ni kong church. Sa lain church ni siya. There was a young boy. Actually, young boy siya. Bantako na siya karon. Actually, he is the pastor of the church right now, Ikson. Ang iyang testimony is this. Sa una daw, gamay pa siya. Kanang timid siya na bata. Ganit ka nang maulawon, hilumon. Di man siya maldito. Pero hilumon siya na halos di siya motingog. Kung di mo siya matamakan, di mo kusiyon, di mo tingog ba? Ingana siya kaulawon, Ikson. But in siya, I felt the love of the church because when I was young, they taught me about the Bible. They taught me about the love of God. They taught me about Jesus Christ and His example. And as I grow up, they encouraged me na kanang maghimo sa ministry in accordance sa akong shape, in accordance sa akong abilities na giyatag ni Lord sa kuha. And ultimately, they licensed me to the ministry, meaning gidawat siya Ikson as the pastor of their church. When that time come na matured na siya enough, Ikson, siya na gimong pastor silang church. And that's how I remembered my church. Ingon pa siya. They love me. But the thing is this, ingon siya. The one thing that I have noticed ever since from the beginning sa church na akong igudakan is this. Nag-away-away man sila. Eh naman dyan ay dinig-sahil, di mo dyan magkasinabot, di ba? But they reconciled instantly. Huwag nilang ipadugay. O wala dyan ko nakabalo, yung mga itong nag-testimony ha, wala dyan ko yung nabantayan na nainihawa sa mong church o nagtuko duglaing simbahan. Nagpabilin sila. Though there are differences, but they want to live that kind of love na gusto ni Lord na they love each other through thick and thin. And that's why, actually, yung patong pastor na akong nabasa yung testimony, hantod karon buo pagyapon sila. They are not a really big church in numbers, but they are big in their heart, in their love for one another. So, ang final question ako, Ikson, is for this. For all of us, dili mga members sa mong church o sa layo mga church, ang pangutana is, do you really love your church? Do you really love your spiritual family? Do you really love your biological family? Because, Ikson, love palagi, if you want to get to the bottom of it, ang bottom line is this, Ikson, you need to put ang kapakanan sa ubang tao ahead of yours. And that is love. Because ang definition ako sa love, Ikson, is this. Love is a self-sacrificing, caring commitment that shows itself in seeking the highest good of others. In short, love acts. I repeat, Ikson, love is a self-sacrificing, caring commitment that shows itself in seeking the highest good of others. Meaning, if you love other people, then you are willing, you are more than willing, Ikson, to lay down your life, to lay down your own kapakanan, and to show them, Ikson, na ang ilang kaayuhan mas importante para sa imuha. And that's what love is all about. Ang model na ito, Ikson, si Jesus Christ, our Lord. And final verse, Ikson. Anyone who does not love does not know God because God is love. So as we close this message, Ikson, kung nakalimutan man yung tanan na akong isulti karon, there's just one thing that I want you to remember. 1 John 4 verse 8. Whoever does not love does not know God because God is love. So if you're a Christian, Ikson, if you're claiming that you love God, you've got to show it, Ikson, by loving other people. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty Father God, our gracious Father God, precious Holy Spirit, Lord, thank you for your love, Lord. Thank you for your amazing love sa muha, O God, that though we are sinners, Lord, you made a way for us, Lord, to spend eternity with you, Lord. You've sent your Son, Jesus Christ, to die on the cross for us to be saved, Lord. And Almighty God, we are forever grateful, Lord, for your love to us, O God. And today, Lord, as we've learned about loving people, I pray, Holy Spirit, tabangin mi, Lord. Giyahin mi, O God. Tudloy mi, Lord, kung saan paghihugma sa isig katao, Lord. Especially those people, Lord, that we may call unloving or unlovable, O God. Because in the end, Lord, we are still the same, Lord. Pare-pareha lang din mi, Lord, in your eyes, O loving God. Walay labaw ka na mo, Lord. Kaya kaming tana, imong mga anak, kaming tana, imong gihugma, O God. And we, as your children, Lord, we need to show that love to each and every one of God. Lord, thank you for your word today. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your miracles, O loving God. Sa tanang tao na minaw karon, Lord, I pray, O loving God, Lord, tanang tudlui jud mi tanan, Lord, na i-apply jud namo sa among life, Lord, ang teachings today, Lord, about loving the family, about loving other people for your glory and for your honor, O God. Once again, God, thank you so much, Lord. We give you back the glory, Lord, the honor and the praises, O God, for you alone deserve it. For you alone are God. And now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord turn His face toward you and give you peace, both now and forevermore. And the people of God will say, Amen and Amen. Once again, mga Ikson, thank you so much for joining us today. Have a nice week, Ikson. Remember, God loves you. Love other people. Bye-bye.
We would like to invite you next week on our Holy Fire and Ignite Youth Fellowship every Friday at 6 p.m. To our online viewers, thank you so much for tuning in to our online Sunday service. See you again next week. God bless.